Hello everyone, Melcadrien here, and I'm here to play Mystik Belle for you people. The reason why I'm playing through this is because this game has had a considerable amount of updates the last few years. Funny how their copyright right there is 2017, where it actually was published a couple of years ago. Well, how long was it? Two? Three? Regardless, the reason why I assume it's now 2017 is because of WayForward publishing this game on the PS4. So yeah, it's an interesting story. A game maker game ends up on a PS4. A lot of game maker games actually end up on the PS4. I mean, let's see, what was that other one that I just thought of at the moment? Risk of Rain? Yeah. Just goes to show that even using a basic game engine for your game can really end up being a big hit. Anyways, that's enough of me jabbering at the moment. Let's play the game. Yes, I want to overwrite this profile. There are two difficulties, probably because they've added the normal difficulty, which is a good starting point for all players. Limited backtracking with warp gate with warp chests restored from current room upon death. Yeah. When I played this game, I played it on hard mode. For arcade adventure veterans, enemies hurt more, no warp chests, return to council chamber upon death. So yeah, it's a little more frustrating, but you know what? I played through this game on hard mode, and I'm gonna play it in hard mode. And the story. One cold late October night, freshman student of the Hagmore School of Witchcraft, Belle McFay was just minding her business, practicing her entry-level fire magic in a shadowy hallway outside her dorm. A sudden chill and a deafening clang of doors flying open startled her. A dark figure darted past, nearly knocking our unfortunate young student off her feet. Before poor Belle could think of a witty retort to such an infuriatingly brazen act of rudeness, a strong grown-up hand grabbed her ear and a cranky old voice said, "Young lady McFay, you're in so much trouble. Next time, clean out your ears." Oh wait, they're actually clean. My fault. "So, what do you have to say for yourself, young lady? What did I do? I seriously have no idea what this is about." "Don't play dumb with us, whippersnapper. You ruined the Walpurgisnack brew with one of your infernals fire spells." "Yeah, that's right, fire spells." "Infernal, I tell ya. Hey, if it was infernal, I wouldn't be standing here. If it was infernal, this whole school would be up in smoke. And why wouldn't you be making it taboo in the first place?" "Oh crap, the brew is ruined? But how could my fire spell cause this? Don't you have any other suspects? Come to think of it, I have seen something, or rather someone..."
"Silence! Insolent child, you're guilty and that's the end of it. Now, you can either atone for your transgression or be expelled from this school at once. Your choice."
"So freaking typical."
"Fine! I'll fix the brew. What do I need?"
"Good. The council accepts your plea. In order to restore the brew, you must find these three items. The Bloom of Twilight, the Claw of a Werewolf, and a Dragon's Scale."
"Dragon scale? A cloth? Really? Where am I gonna get this stuff, especially on this short notice?"
"That, young lady, isn't our concern, but I would suggest looking for some of those items in the dark forest."
"Yes, some might be found within the walls of this very school. Yes. Are you chewing taffy over there? You'll never know."
"Be careful, girl. Walpurgisnack is near and the spirits are restless. The danger awaits you around every corner."
Fantastic. This sounds utterly insane. So just expel me now, please. You're a homeroom teacher. Miss Willow bears all responsibility for the actions of her students. She'll be working on the brew along with you. Go see her first.
Yes. And we get to talk to these three, who are just standing behind these podiums. Aren't you three going to be doing anything? Especially all those witches behind us. Are you going to be doing anything?
No, we're just going to stand here and wait for you to finish the job.
Why?
Well, for one reason, we don't want to leave our nice cozy podiums.
Yes. Let's see. How do I converse? C key. Okay.
Being a proper young witch, you must take responsibility for your own misdeeds.
But I didn't do it! Surely you must realize that on some level.
Dumb girl, what have you done?
But I really didn't do anything.
I guess it makes no difference now.
Yes, it does. I don't want to get expelled for something I didn't do.
And if the potion isn't restored on time, it wouldn't even matter.
Might as well grab the hall pass.
Yes, it's an apple, but it's also a hall pass. Don't know why, it just is.
You're in luck, girl. The Bloom of Twilight can only be found during the full moon around Walpurgisnacht. Also, I've got some butterscotch candy. It blooms in the shade of the oldest tree in the forest.
I see.
For your information, girl, there just happens to be a werewolf stalking the floor dungeon of this castle. So if you plan on getting a claw of a werewolf, here's your best bet. Just be ready for a fight.
Splendid. Thank you, though.
Let's see if I can get as much information out of these three.
No one has seen a dragon around these parts in a millennia. But an old legend has it. A dragon once lived in a cave in the middle of our forest. If you're searching hard enough, you just might find your scale.
Or a dragon. Thank you, Miss Kukinski.
Yeah. Repeating herself.
What do you mean my expulsion wouldn't matter? That sounded ominous as all heck.
You're not gonna answer her?
What do you...
Nah, she's not gonna answer that.
If you didn't do it, as you insist, then who did?
I already told you! I was practicing that someone ran past me. The jerk almost knocked me off my feet.
Silent, since you have come to such close contact with our mysterious someone, you surely must know who it was and what he or she looks like. Well, no, it was dark, and as I said, I was practicing. I'm sure it was either a kid or at least someone small. That sounds fascinating, but you have nothing to back your story up, and it was you who were caught.
Yeah, I was busy practicing my fire spell and someone ran past me and you just ran right up and grabbed me by the ear, jerk. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Done talking to them.
Where does it think it's going? No hall pass? Can't go.
I'm gonna have to take some time to relearn the controls.
No pass? Edna, punch your face in.
Can you please don't? Okay, might as well use the hall pass.
Oi, that's the ticket. Firehead no leave pass anywhere or he will come.
Who's he?
No joke, he. Hall monitor.
It's a school. Of course there's a hall monitor.
Moving along.
All we have for our weapon is a basic fire spell, but killing a lot of enemies will allow us to upgrade our
basic fire spell to something much more effective later on. Also, running into enemies causes you to insta-kill some enemies. I don't know why, it just does. I mean, I fell on that enemy and it just exploded. Ow! There we go. I want to get in as much experience as possible. Because I want to be able to have my best fire spell when the boss fights come. I do have to say one thing. I friggin' love the art style in this game. This has a lot of dedication to it. Dang, I really need to get to work on improving mine. Oh, mine's not all that good. This is a huge yellow tank full of toxic weed killer. Yep, weed killer. For the tough on weeds. I like it when I get in melee with Belle, because he just goes and melees them. Here we have a warp mirror. This is one of the travel mirrors, or so I've been told. They're used to quickly get around the school, but only works if one knows where the other ones like it are located. Unfortunately, this is the only one I know of. Yeah. Yeah. But this actually makes a good place for leaving all your items around, because you're going to have a lot of inventory, a lot of items, and this game plays like Dizzy. To those who don't know about Dizzy, it is an old game, and I only know about it because, well, I saw games about it. Got the spray pump, now let's talk to our teacher. Oh, Belle, what have you done? Madame Hagmore is furious, and we're almost out of time to recreate the brew. Mrs. Willow, please believe me, I had nothing to do with this. I was just practicing in the hallway. There was some crazy clatter, and some jerk almost knocked me off my feet. The next thing I know, I'm being dragged into the council chambers. This changes everything. Why did you tell that to the council? I can barely get a word in. They seem to have made up their mind even before I opened my mouth. Well, this is bad. Not only do we have to get all these rare ingredients, but also watch out for whoever sabotaged the brew in the first place. Either way, be careful, Belle, and be sure to bring me the ingredients as you find them. I'll try to help you as much as I can, but the Walpurgisnacht brew requires me to constantly keep an eye on it. Yeah. Back so soon? Did you find any of the ingredients? Not yet, Mrs. Willow, but I'm on it. We can also show her some items. Let's see. Nope, that's not what I wanted to do. Here we go. Just pull up the item and show it to her. Use it. Hey, that's mine! Desperate times, desperate measures, Miss Willow. I totally need it. For stuff. I guess. Well, make sure you don't go spraying poison all over the school. And we also have the hall pass. Yeah, fake apple or not, keep this thing on you at all times. You never know when you run into a hall monitor. No joke. And hall monitors are... they're lethal. So always keep your hall pass with you at all times. I guess because it's not normal school hours, you have to use the hall pass. There we go, leveled up our magic. Doesn't seem to have done any difference so far, but it'll show some potent differences, I'm hoping. A Unless they change the game up a bit. Yeah. Can't lug the whole thing around, but we can use this to pick up a full, well, some toxic weed killer. Now that we have this weed killer, what are we gonna do with it? Are we gonna spray it on everyone? No. Although I would be interested if what our teacher would say now that we have a full pump full of weed killer. My spray can, full of poison. Make sure you don't kill anyone or anything important with this. Oh, hello, what do we have here? Some rubbish. Someone doesn't know how to clean up their school. Oh, hello, what do we have here? This mop has turned orange after one too many magical accident cleanups. It could even pass for some punky hairdo. Well, maybe from a distance, in a dark room, while blackout drunk. The sign reads, warning, approaching the carnivorous plants will result in instant death and expulsion from the school. Note, carnivorous plants are magic proof. Shooting it will only make it angrier. Whoa. Well, we do have some weed killer. Excellent idea, except I have to use the spray pump from a much closer range. Okay. Take that! And we're gonna guard ourselves some stinky leaves. Always pick up everything, because you may never know what use they may have. Even rubbish may be useful. And with that, the path over here is clear, apparently. Eh. Well, we have two ways to go. We have the forest, well, the path to the forest, if I remember correctly, and the path over there, I think. The bridge release mechanism is stuck. No matter how hard I lean on the lever, I can't budge it even a millimeter. Scratch that. Looks like I'm gonna have to go the other way. I kind of forgot about that. Hey, it's been a while, okay? Hey, Nikki, what are you doing here so late? Late? Oh, I guess it really is. This book is so freaking great. Oh, well, I guess I'll just finish it. Can you help me look for some brew ingredients? Like a fun scavenger hunt type thing? Sorry, Belle, you know I'm useless when it comes to real world stuff. In fact, I might be allergic to scavenger hunts. Impossibly fun. You're having fun reading a book. Still reading? Yeah, Belle, this is some awesome stuff. Now please let me be. Can we talk to you again? Oh well. I guess that's all we can get from her. Let's see. Hello, this looks a little off. It looks like someone tried to break off a piece of this curtain rod, but failed miserably. Amateurs. Yeah, that's pretty blatant. You can see it from a mile away. That and it's doing the whole glowy shiny thing. Detention dungeon. Well, might as well check out what's down here. And beat up some enemies while at it. Oh, there was something down there. Maybe some useful item. Ah, here we go. Here I was worried it was going to be some death pit. It's not. We got a skull. Alas, poor Yurik. No idea what the skull is gonna be for. But hey, it's gonna be useful somewhere. Warning, laser beavers. Okay, I guess that's out. Guess that's all we're gonna be able to get from here. So, back up we go. I just love the melee mechanic. It's like, if you get one to really dish some serious damage, you get up in close and personal. You're gonna risk taking a lot of damage though, but you'll get a ton of it. Well, you'll deal a lot of damage from it. Ow. Ghost pork? Ew. Ow. Well, that happened. Belle fainted and lost all experience. What do we do now? Okay, so this isn't new. I'd never seen this. Return to council chambers and exit the main menu. Well, we are extremely disappointed. Well, Perkisnot isn't upon us, and instead of fixing the brew, you have ruined... You were napping? What are you talking about? I've been knocked out. Lying doesn't befit a young witch such as yourself. Well, there's that. Losing all experience. I don't think that's... Did that really happen when I first played this game? Probably. But that game over screen, that was new. That was completely, totally, and utterly new. Anyways, I need to start dropping some items. No, I don't want to drop the hall pass. I want to drop the... You know, I have no idea what I need to drop. Well, I do need to drop the nail clippers. That I have no reason for at this time. Or the skull. That'll have to do. The reason why I'm dropping my items there is because of my limited inventory space. I don't want to end up just having to run to a warp mirror because I've ran out of space. There's some health. Why didn't you drop some for me before I got knocked out, huh? Hi, Romana. Romana Strong, independent woman, also depressed. Go make fun of Romana. Go away. I never made fun of you. No matter. All girls mean. Make fun of Romana Bald Head. Romana can't do nothing. One half troll. Huh. Hey, cheer up. It's not so bad. Easy for fire hair girl to say. Romana wish have fair fire like fire. Hmm. Fire hair, huh? Well, I do remember there being a mop that has some fire hair, sort of. Maybe that could be of some use. Ow! Yes, I just bodied all of those. That's gonna be annoying. Oh, hello. Aw, it's midnight. Mrs. Willow's adorable kitty. Can't resist the cuteness. Must pet kitten.
Slap.
Holy crap. This furball over here is one heck of a static charge on it. Well, shocking cat. Gotta be careful around that. Give me some health. Thank you. This thing looks really flimsy. Even though vandalism really isn't my thing, let's see what it does. Flimsy chain.
You know what? I'll take it.
You may never know when you need a chain for something.
I want to go up, not fall down.
Sometimes picks on perfect jumps are annoying. And sometimes you just fall through the steps because you didn't press it on time. Okay, what do we have over here? Ah, the kitchen. Hello, Mr. Butterworts. Miss?
What the heck are you doing in my shit? What are you doing?
No, that's not the voice I want.
What are you doing in my kitchen? Get out, shoo!
This food here smells good. Can I please have some?
No, I don't cook for student brats. No scram!
I see. Okay. Nothing over here. Looks like there's a pry bar up there, but we can't get up there right at the moment. Hello, what do we have here? This is a huge smelly dumpster full of all sorts of wizardly waste. That's so. Well, maybe we should make use of it. Somewhere. Somehow. This is a heavy metal hatch. Even though it has a handle, I can't seem to open it without leverage of some sort.
We are barred from going down there at the moment. So I suppose the only way we can go is up.
Hello. Can I, kill you? No. Come on, come on. I failed the jump. Come on, let's try again. Belle, come on. Oh well. I guess I won't be getting it at the moment.
That's just a metal foil.
Shiny. Shouldn't take any while Butterworts is watching. How about just a simple sandwich?
Get lost. You students are like pests, always bug me for something. You're all annoying like flies.
I guess that's a no then.
Would you like some rubbish?
She looks really pissed off. I better not mess with her. The flies seem to be taking a liking to, our lunch lady here.
You know what I'm thinking? I'm thinking we should get some more flies.
Oh, we leveled up. Our shots don't seem to be bigger yet. Well, they will be. I'm sure of it. Although I do think our health bar is expanding, is it? Maybe it is. Okay, let's try this jump again. Stop. Stop it, stupid bat. Well, we got on the platform. Now we can go up. Come on. Ow! What do we have here? Glass jar. That should be useful for something. There's a hermit lizard living here. Hermit lizards often rock some very sturdy household containers as shells. And he seems to be liking apples. So, let's give him an apple. Oh. Yeah. They will eat anything remotely like an apple. So let's give him an apple. Yoink! Uh-oh. I have full inventory. I'm gonna have to drop something. I'll drop the rubbish. Ow! My shots are bouncing back at me. Come on. Maybe if I stand... Oh! You're just gonna... Well, I suppose this will have to do. There we go. Well, I have a full inventory.